Hi there, Panda here. I'm just going to make another vlog about more Doctor Who stuff because, like a month ago, I received some things that I've been having fun with. And no, before you ask, it's not my penis. I'm going to resume. I've been watching Doctor Who a lot lately, and I've been receiving, yay, the complete four series that I already told you. But also the complete specials, there's that. It's David Tennant. I don't want to go. But David, you have to go. Your time is over. We have to change the doctor. Really? Yeah. Oh, all right. I just go. And finally, for Christmas, season 5. Magnificent season 5. I didn't finish watching it, so please, no spoilers. You will be kind enough. Come on, open. Yeah, you go. The missing DVD that is on my PS3 right now because I'm watching it. Booklets, picture, that's awesome. So let's resume. Why I'm here today to make a video about some things that I received, like I told you. I know there's a lot of videos about what I'm going to show you, but I thought I was going to make one on my own, but using dry humor. Because when it's used properly, it can be fun and enjoyable for everybody. Like my penis. Anyway. Here he comes. Dun, 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 dun. The 10th Doctor Screwdriver. Special thanks to Linkara for giving me the links. First off, I paid $20 without the shipping on ThingGeek.net, I believe. And for some odd reasons, I live in France, and it was more expensive to buy it from the UK. It was £90. So anyway, let's check that thing. You can probably see me on the camera. Hello. So first things that bother me with that box, it's basically David Tennant is here. No problem because it's a 10th Doctor screwdriver. But Matt Smith is here too. And correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that Matt Smith only used this screwdriver in the first episode of the 5th season. Then he got his own one. So I call bullshit on you, Matt Smith. You can see three holes here because it's the batteries. They're not here. So let's check a little bit the box. The 10th Doctor screwdriver featuring Matt Smith. Bullshit. Feature UV pen and UV light to write and reveal hidden messages just like the Doctor do. No, he never did that. Slide out sonic wave emitter with two sonic sound effects. I will go back on that. Limited edition pack. Yeah, it's so limited that you can find another version of the 10th Doctor screwdriver. I believe it's the same, the exact same, but it's a big cardboard box with the psychic paper inside. Okay, you're going to tell me the psychic paper is just a bland piece of paper. I know, but still, you know. 5 plus with ultraviolet light and pen, just to say. Choking hazard, no sad onion. No. BBC logo. Let's check on the back. Buzz. Kinda realistic, yes. Oh, the side onion is here. Hello. The how to put the batteries, blah blah blah, so no. An extension of the TARDIS fantastic advanced technology. This is the Doctor's second best friend. Alright, I don't want to know what it does with it. But anyway, we're going to open it, and I'm going to use my special Ashen's power to open the box. There you go. If you paid attention to what I said that I opened the box like a month ago. Pay attention. Anyway, let's check this. The little manual. And this is one of the problems I got with this pen. It's basically they tell you that you get two different sounds. And from Welshie, I know that on the 11th Doctor screwdriver, you get two position or even three to get different sound. On this one, at no point they explain you how to play the two different sounds. And I'm going to explain you that a little bit later. They just explain you how to remove the pen. It's not rocket science, dude. Look at that. Get out of here. There. This is how you remove the pen. Wow. Nobody's impressed. So here's the screwdriver. Look at it, it's marvelous. I'm sorry I don't have Internet Personality Evangelist camera work to straight to you better, but I like this because you can find a cheaper version of this screwdriver for like $4 or $5, but you don't have all these details on it. It's just details, but it makes a difference, I believe. So the blue tip, and now I'm going to get that closer to my microphone to make you hear the two different sounds. So first you press here to have the sound, and when it's out, you press here because they couldn't figure out just one button. Anyway, let's hear this fantastic sound. Sound one. Sound two. Can you hear a difference? Autofocus, please. Come back. Come back, autofocus. Doesn't want to. I'm going to make you listen to that because I figured that out after a while. Basically, the two sounds are on the same button. You would play sound one when you press one time and sound two when you press two times. Look. Pay attention. Sound one. And now sound two. There's a slight difference, but really, it's kind of joking. But for the price, again, it's still a good product. Then it can come out, and I really like what they did here. If the autofocus, yeah. Kind of a drill thingy inside. It's looking pretty nice. I'm pretty sure it's plastic, but it looked like metal, so that's cool. Here, the entire pan, and again, you just switch here instead of here when it's out. Sound one, sound two, it never gets old. And last feature, you got a pen. You know, just like the doctor when he writes his check. Anyway, the pen is here. And it's kind of shit. Just me, just to hold it. Most of the time, when we will try to hold it, if you hold it like a retard like me, the top will come out a little bit like that, will become loose. Because basically, all the ink you got inside this pen is here. And I don't think you can replace it. When it's empty, it's empty. Deal with it. It's life. It's tough. So anyway, here the pen function. And for the last part, the interesting part, you got a UV pen, which is just right here. And in case you're a moron, they tell you again, UV ink nib. So you just use your degree in rocket science to replay that. There you go. And now you get this ugly ribbon on top of it. Remove that part, and you can see the little difference. UV pen, regular pen. And there you go. That's all the mystery you got around this screwdriver. It's pretty neat. It's completely useless, but I like it. You can't even use it as a pen because, like I told you, this part is really too shaky to do anything. So, just really to show off and have a battle with Welshy. There you go. The 10th Doctor screwdriver. And I'm going to show you what this part is for.